Ah, New Jersey, known for Italians, Bruce Springsteen, the Jersey Devil, questionable theme parks being unfairly referred to as New York's little sibling, the Jersey Shore, Italians at the Jersey Shore, and lots of land development. Like, lots of it. In fact, as of 2015, a third of the Garden State had been developed, making it the most developed state in the nation. But when we look at that development by county, we see that it's not equally distributed. Let's first look at the percent change in acres of land categorized as urban from 1995 to 2015. We see that the northern counties, right outside of New York City, didn't see much change because they're already a part of New York City's urban sprawl. But as we move south, away from the city and toward the suburbs, exurbs, and farmland, we see a larger increase in urban land use. And in 20 years, not a single county declined in urban acreage. However, every county saw a decline in forested acres in the same amount of time. I want to point out Ocean County here, and not just because it's where I'm from. Although Ocean County only saw about a 10% decrease in forested area, it did see the largest overall decline in acreage in the whole state. Nearly 20,000 acres of forest were lost between 1995 and 2015. But the story of land use in New Jersey is not all bad. Even though a third of the state has been developed in the past 30 years, more than half of it has been protected or constrained during the same period. Experts estimate that 14% of the state is still developable. They argue that we must be diligent in our use of the remaining undeveloped land in New Jersey, and that the future of the most densely populated state in the nation must be redevelopment if we are to preserve the Garden State's natural beauty.